Experiment with sous vide. First steak ever cooked sous vide style.
You ready? Let's go!
Alright, so today you're going to be joining me on a new food journey. I've actually got another cooker that I never anticipated getting, and I tell you what, this is going to be a game changer for me. I'm going to be learning a lot about this process and how to use this cooker, and during that process I'm going to share with you my tips, tricks, mistakes, and everything else. And I tell you what, this is going to be fun. And such time with that being said, I'm going to actually be sharing with you what I'm going to be using as far as a cooker. But what I'm going to be doing as I begin to start my next food journey as it relates to cooking, I want to share with you a recipe for making a unique compound butter. I've actually never used this before, but I feel like the ingredients are going to work well with the intended cook that I'm going to be doing with this new cooker. So follow along. Let me know what you think in the comments down below. Don't forget that subscribe button. Like I said, it's a full new journey, and I can't wait to share this with you. So I've gotten this softened butter. It's basically a Kerrygold pure Irish unsalted butter. That's what I'm going to be using as a stick. That's the first ingredient, obviously. It's been softened, so I'm not too worried about that. Next thing I'm going to do is take some of the zest of the lime, and I'm going to start putting that in there. This is going to be a unique flavor set, but there's a reason for it. Not only for the cut that I'm going to be cooking in this new cooker, but also because I think this is going to be the perfect match as far as pairing flavors with this particular cut. So that's why I'm using this. I think it's going to be good. Found this recipe online, and I'm going to share the recipe down below just so you have it too in case you want to use it. Basically using a minced jalapeno. I love this little core thing. It's worked out well for me, especially if you're doing jalapeno poppers, but I'm not doing that today. I'm just taking out the core with the seeds so I can get all that out. And look at that. Look how easy it was. Works out perfect. I'm gonna still make sure I get all the seeds washed out of there, and I'm gonna mince this up. One thing I like to do is make sure I always get the vein out. That's always key for me, at least for the jalapenos themselves, especially when using it minced in another dish. I also do the same with poblanos. But yeah, like I said, I'm taking the vein out. That is actually where pretty much all the heat is when it comes to these. Most people think it's the seeds, but no, it's actually the vein. So I'm taking all that out, cleaning that up, get this minced up, get that into the butter, go from there. Now that I've got the jalapeno minced up, just gonna throw that in there, and we'll get on to the next step. Some paprika, just like that. Smoked paprika, actually. Now it's time to start doing the initial mix for this compound butter. Like I said, this is definitely a unique set of flavors with the jalapeno and the lime. But once you understand the cut that I'm using, I think it'll make a lot more sense. And like I said, using this smoked paprika, I think it's gonna add a little bit of color to this cut as well. I got one more ingredient I'm getting ready to show you, so stay tuned for that, and we'll get this rolled up. Ingredient, black garlic. I'm just gonna take off a little sliver of this to put it in there. I think this adds a little bit of depth and richness to this compound butter, and we'll see how it goes. You can see I got that black garlic cut up. Just gonna put that in there. I'm gonna get this mixed up really good. Again, this will make a lot more sense once you understand what I'm cooking with and why I'm using these ingredients as far as the cut. But I tell you what, this is gonna be good. Can't wait to roll this up. We'll get this into the refrigerator overnight. And I'm hoping this is gonna be an amazing cook, like I think it will. That, I tell you what, it smells amazing. I cannot wait to try out this compound butter. I think it's gonna be an excellent combination with the cut that I'm using. So let's get this wrapped up in the saran wrap. Let's see what it looks like. I'm gonna roll this up, and then eventually, we're gonna be able to use this for my very first cook with the new cooker. And I am definitely excited to see how this turns out. I've made compound butter before. I've never made this version, obviously. But I think it's going to turn out great. It's going to work out really good, this cut, and for this new cooker that I'm using. There you have it, in saran wrap. We're going to get this to the refrigerator overnight, and tomorrow we'll be using this. Welcome to my next cooking journey. like I talked about the other day, or just yesterday I should say, I have a new cooker. I'm getting ready to unveil it. We're going to be doing testing this to a variety of different cooks, proteins, a lot of other things. I've been grilling and cooking and smoking in the kitchen for some time. From what I understand, this takes things to the next level. So we're going to find out. I'm going to give you an honest review of this product. I'm going to let you know if it works. I'm going to show you through all the different types of proteins that I'm going to use it for. And we're talking about sous vide. This is an Anova precision cooker. I am certainly looking forward to trying this out. This is one of the reasons I made that compound butter that basically consisted of jalapeno, lime, obviously unsalted butter, as well as some smoked paprika and a little bit of black garlic. I'm gonna be using that on a new cut that I've never also had before, but a Merlot steak, which is essentially a lot like a flank steak to my understanding. So I'll be basically using the sous vide to cook this steak, and of course we'll get that final sear on the grill. I am so excited about this adventure. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button and those notifications if you want to see all the new cooks that I'm going to be doing with the sous vide. We're going to run through anything and everything, and I'm going to be trying some creative new recipes with this cooker. So I'm certainly excited about it. Let's get into it and let's have some fun. So here we go. Here's those Merlot steaks I was talking about. Basically, you can see these are smaller cuts. They're supposed to be like a flank steak, so I'm gonna be doing those. Also have fortunately, I also have this little flat iron, which I'm gonna do as well for my son. So let's get into it. I'll show you how I'm gonna prep these to get them ready for sous vide. Things first, basically I got my steaks out here. I'm gonna basically be using this baby got butter from Gasket Vite. That's what I've been using this recently on steaks. So I'm gonna use this as kind of the base layer. And then I'm gonna come in behind it, since I'm kind of doing something, not necessarily fajita style, but a little bit of a, I guess you could say more of a Brazilian type of cook, is I'm also gonna be using another seasoning. It's basically a Brazilian steakhouse barbecue blend. So basically getting this all on here, I think this is gonna be good. I'm not gonna put a lot in here, just enough to kind of get it some flavor. Like I said, it's really just a base, because you're still gonna need to season up your steaks. Now I'm gonna use that steakhouse barbecue blend. And I'm gonna get that on there. It's got a nice little blend to it. So definitely sure it will work well with this butter that I'm getting ready to do. All right, now that I've got these seasoned up, basically I'm gonna be taking these little bags that I've already pre-made. I've also basically acquired the Anova sealer as well. My food saver was pretty much on the verge of biting the dust, and I just wanted to see if it was gonna work any better. You know, I've had the food saver a couple of different ones, and they seemed to crap out after a little while, so I thought I would try something different. See if this works any better. Just basically getting each one of these into the bag. We'll end up sealing these up. Next, basically gonna be taking the compound butter, which smells amazing. You can smell the lime and the jalapeno in there. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just basically going to slice off where I think I need to, and just put a little bit of dollop of each one of these into the bag, like so, as you can see, and that's going to be sealed up, and then we'll eventually get this into the sous vide. Sous vide is going to go for, from what I understand, about 2 hours, and then we'll flash grill it there at the end, and should be interesting to see how it tastes, that's for sure. I've never used a sous vide, so this is all new to me, and it's basically a brand new learning experience. All right, now that I got these on there, I got this done, I'm gonna go ahead and get everything back into the into the kitchen, get everything sealed up, and then we'll get ready to go. So there you have it. I've got this sealed up into the Anova sealed bags. I'm gonna get this into the refrigerator until we cook this a little bit later on today, but I think this is gonna work. I hope it works out great. If it doesn't, I'm gonna let you know. I really believe it could work out great. I've never done this before, so this is all new to me. You're getting to learn as I'm going through the process, and I'll certainly share anything else that I like or don't like about this process. I can tell you one, I'm not a very patient person, so waiting for this to cook over that duration will obviously be a little bit, but you know, other than that, I feel pretty confident this is gonna turn out good, and I'm certainly excited about this. You can see I'm getting the Nova started. Basically, I'm trying to get this up to a temperature of 130 with the container, and then we'll get the steaks in there, and then we're gonna basically be doing this based on the instructions that I have for a recipe, which looks like it needs to be set at 129.5 for 4 hours. I'm using this perfect flat iron steak. One hopes that it'll be transferred to the Merlot steak as well as the flat iron steak. We will see. Definitely a lot of good recipes on here, so I'm certainly looking forward to see how this turns out. We will end up searing this in the cast iron with another addition of some other ingredients. So stay tuned. This should be fun. Flat iron steak going in, along with the two Merlot steaks. I got it set at 129.5. It's supposed to cook for 4 hours, and then we'll get it onto the cast iron skillet on the grill. Should be interesting. Certainly intrigued to see how this turns out. My first cook on the Sous Vide, and certainly hope the results are worth it. These steaks are almost done with their 4 hour bath in the Sous Vide. Getting ready to get these onto the iron skillet, and also be using some of that compound butter to cook them in. So definitely looking forward to seeing this turn out. Certainly excited to see the end result. Those steaks came out of the Sous Vide, as you can see, or maybe you can't see, but these things are still tender, so I'm curious as to once we get these on the iron skillet what they're gonna be like. Should be an interesting experiment. I'm gonna be using that compound butter to cook these in that I put this in with the steaks. All right, so those steaks have been resting for about 3 to 4 minutes, another minute to go. Basically, you can see they don't look pretty right now, but hopefully they'll look good after they've been in the cast iron for a little bit. Stay tuned for the end of this. Definitely look forward to seeing how it turns out. Should be an interesting, intriguing meal. See there, I'm adding this compound butter that I made yesterday. Putting that in there. And we'll get the steaks on here. See how it goes. True. Get the steaks in there. Sear them about 1 minute per side. See how it looks. Moment of truth. Let's slice into it. Well, there you have it. Look at that. Definitely perfect edge to edge. Let's check out the other steak. Pretty perfect edge to edge as well. And then last but not least, let's look at this flat iron. Look at that. Definitely juicy and tender. Let's get it out there and see how it tastes. Moment of truth. My first Sous Vide grilled steak, if you will, or you know, obviously cooked and then grilled steak. I've learned a little bit more patience with this process, and I can tell you right now, the meat is certainly more tender than if it had just been grilled. Is it really worth the investment of having one? I'm not sure. There's still a lot of more experiments to go, but let's go ahead, dig into this, and I'll tell you what I think. The flavors from the compound butter to the seasoning, everything is basically inherently into the steak. You can taste every bite. I will say it is a bit more tender than say it had been on a grill, and it adds, it's incredibly flavorful. Definitely something I'll be trying again with a different variety of cuts. If I was to tell you right now to buy one, I would say I'm on the fence. To be honest with you, I don't know if it's really worth the investment, but I have a lot more proteins to try. I have chicken, I have ribs, I have a lot of different things, including a brisket that I'm going to be trying with this. And I'll just acknowledge, you know, if honestly it works, if it doesn't work, what it does. Right now it seems to do well. I just don't know if the time and effort really has its dividends at the end of the day. I definitely a fun experiment. More of these coming up in the future. Like I said, we'll be doing chicken, ribs, a variety of things. So stay tuned, hit that subscribe button, and don't forget those notifications. Until next time, good cooking.